Hi, it's Dibyajyoti Mahapatra. Welcome to my channel, DJM Physics.
Hi students. Today we are going to continue our topic, Schwarzschild law in vector addition, and also we will solve some numericals using the special cases that we are going to derive. So before that, if you have not checked yet the previous video, kindly go through that, because this video is completely based on the previous one. Okay, so let me first write what we learn in the last class. In the last class we learn that if there are two vectors, let it is A vector and this is B vector, if there are two vectors making an angle theta acting at a particular point, then the resultant will come something like this. Let it is R vector, okay, and this angle, this resultant will go by making an angle of beta with A vector, where R is given by, or R vector magnitude, that I can write simply as R, that can be given by A square plus B square plus 2AB cos theta root over, and this angle beta, or I can write tan beta equal to B sin theta divided by A plus B cos theta. So these were the general formulas which we have derived using triangle law of vector addition. If you are given with two vectors, A vector and B vector, which are acting at an angle of theta to each other, then the resultant you cannot get by A plus B. You have to use a special formula known as triangle law of vector addition, and by using that you can find that a resultant vector will be of magnitude this much, and it will go by making an angle beta, where beta can be found by using this expression. Okay, up to this we have learned. Is this part visible? Let me just check. Okay, so there are some special cases here. Let me write down all the special cases. In physics, there are some angles which are, or while dealing with vectors, there are some angles which are normally, which are generally used. Because due to the calculation purpose, in real life angle can be anything else, but in physics or in exam you will find many angles which will be given particular some angle, like 90 degree, 0 degree, 180 degree, 120 degree. All these angles are very special, because if you take those angles as theta, then this formula will become somewhat simpler. That is why we are going to derive those formula by using special cases. And also in physics, in class 12 normally you are going to check that this angle 90 degree, angle between two vector is 90 degree. Like that, many examples you will get, or many situation we will get, where the two vectors will be acting along each other by making an angle of 90 degree. So if we change this formula, or if the theta value will be used as 90 degree or as 0 degree or as 180 degree, in those cases, if you derive the formulas, these formulas, by putting theta as 0 or 180 or 90 or 120 like that, then this formula will become easier and smaller to use in real cases. Let us check what I am telling by example. Special case 1, if theta equal to 0 degree. Okay, if theta equal to 0 degree means, what do you mean by that? Two vectors are there, one is A vector, another one is B vector, and angle between them is 0 degree. Means like this, this angle between them is 0 degree. So if two vectors act like this, then, and if you put this value there, then what you will get? R will be equal to A square plus B square प्लस 2 इंटू ए इंटू बी इंटू कॉस 0 डिग्री रूट ओवर, बट कॉस 0 इज 1, सो दिस इज नथिंग बट ए स्क्वायर प्लस बी स्क्वायर प्लस 2 ए बी रूट ओवर, बिकॉज कॉस 0 इक्वल टू 1, दिस इज इक्वल टू 1. ओके, नाउ दिस इज नथिंग बट ए प्लस बी होल स्क्वायर एंड इट्स रूट ओवर इज देयर, सो द आंसर विल बी ए प्लस बी. सो व्हाट वी गॉट, दैट आर इक्वल टू ए प्लस बी. एंड सिमिलरली इफ यू फाइंड, इफ यू पुट थीटा इक्वल टू 0 डिग्री इन दिस एक्सप्रेशन, टैन बीटा इक्वल टू बी साइन 0 डिग्री डिवाइडेड बाय ए प्लस बी कॉस 0 डिग्री. साइन 0 इज 0, कॉस 0 इज 1, सो आई कैन राइट टैन बीटा इक्वल टू 0 बाय ए प्लस बी, दैट इज इक्वल टू 0. नाउ इफ टैन बीटा इक्वल टू 0, देन व्हाट इज द वैल्यू ऑफ बीटा? 0 डिग्री. सो नो, फॉर व्हाट वैल्यू टैन विल बिकम 0? इफ यू चेक द टैन टेबल यू विल फाइंड टैन 0 इक्वल टू 0, सो हियर बीटा इक्वल टू 0 डिग्री. ओके, इट मीन्स दीज आर द कंक्लूजन्स. इट मीन्स इफ देर आर टू वेक्टर्स लाइक दिस, देन द आर वेक्टर विल मेक 0 डिग्री विथ ए वेक्टर, बिकॉज व्हाट इज बीटा? बीटा इज द एंगल बिटवीन ए वेक्टर एंड आर वेक्टर. Means if two vectors are like this, then beta also will be 0 degree. Means beta will go like this, making an angle 0 degree with a vector. And what is the value of this r? This is r vector. What will be the magnitude of r? It will be equal to a plus b. Okay, let me again explain this. What does this mean? If there are two forces, let a 5 Newton force and a 7 Newton force act like this. By making an angle of 0 degree with each other, then what is the resultant? You don't have to go for these formulas. You simply write r equal to a plus b. Means simply add them. Means what will be the r here, or what is the net force on the object? 12 Newton along this direction. What is the magnitude of this vector will be? 12 Newton. This is the net force on the object. So when two vectors acting like with 0 degree, and this already we know in the lower classes, and this came from here. If two forces acting along same direction, add them. Why to add them? They are vectors. Then how we can simply add them? We can simply add them because in vector addition also, if you put this theta equal to 0 degree, you can check that the vectors are simply added algebraically. And remember, this is the only case where r is coming as a plus b. This is the only case. Nowhere else you can do. Means, if the angle between two vectors is 0 degree, then you can add them algebraically. Simply a plus b, nothing else. And beta is 0 degree, or you can remember that the resultant will be in the same direction of these two vectors. Okay, so this is one case. If you understood this derivation, these are very simple derivation. If you understood, it's okay. If you have not understood, or if you don't want to derive all this, then at least remember the result and the meaning of the result. Okay. Now let us come to the second case. If theta equal to 180 degree. If theta equal to 180 degree. Then what will be the value of r? R equal to this formula as we know. A square plus b square plus 2ab cos 180 degree. Now cos 180 is minus 1. So if this is minus 1, it will become minus. It is a minus b whole square, and r will be equal to a minus. Okay. Similarly, if you find this beta, I'm not deriving that. If you will find this, okay, I can write here either a minus b or you can write it here as b minus a whole square root over also. So you can write r equal to b minus a also. So a r will be equal to either a minus b or r will be equal to b minus a. What do you mean by this? If there are two vectors making an angle of 180 degree with each other, 180 degree means like this. If A vector is like this and B vector is like this, angle between them is 180 degree. Okay, in this case, what will the value of R? And let me write the round value of beta here itself. Beta will be equal to 0 degree. If in this case you will get beta will be equal to 0 degree, or in this case you will get beta will be equal to 180 degree. You can solve this or you can simply remember. R will be equal to A minus B and beta equal to 0, or you can get R equal to B minus A and beta equal to 180 degree. What do you mean by this? And when this will used, when this will be used? If this is like given like this, A vector and B vector making an angle 180 degree, then what will be the R? R will be here along this direction. And what will be the magnitude of R? A minus B. Okay, and when it is going to be used, see, if A is greater, for example, again you have used it already, let 7 newton force is along this direction and some 3 newton force, or let some 2 newton force is along this direction, then what is the resultant? How you are finding 7 minus 2? Why you are making 7 minus 2? When you are adding two vectors, here two vectors are at a time applied on an object. Now why you are subtracting them? You are subtracting them due to this result, because this result is A minus B. Okay, so it will be 7 minus 2 or equal to 5 newton along this direction. This will be your R vector or the resultant force on the object. Now what is the beta value here? Beta is the angle between A vector and R vector. So what is the angle between these two? 0 degree. Is it clear? So R equal to A minus B and beta equal to 0. Or if it is not given like this, rather let A is smaller vector and B is a bigger vector or larger vector, then what will be the resultant? Resultant will come along this direction, whose this is R vector, and this R will be equal to B minus A. Now what is the angle between R vector and A vector? You can see that it is 180 degree. So if R equal to B minus A, beta will be equal to 180 degree. Okay. So you can remember it like this. If you remember this formula, then also okay. Otherwise you can remember, if there are two vectors making an angle 180 degree with each other, just subtract them. The resultant you can get by subtracting them. And along which direction the resultant will go? Along the direction where, in which direction the larger vector is there, was there. Means, if this is 7 newton, along this direction 2 newton, 7 minus 2 along the larger vector, means along this direction. This is the 5 newton or the result. If this is 2 newton and along this direction 7 newton, then again 7 minus 2, but along this direction, along the larger vector. So along 5 newton, along this direction. Is it clear? So this is the answer. That is why actually in the lower classes we are using, if two forces are acting along same direction, add them. If two forces are acting along opposite direction, subtract them. Actually those addition and subtraction came from here. Okay. Now here very carefully remember that if two vectors are like this added, I cannot write here, okay, let this is A vector and this is B vector, a smaller vector, and R vector is along this direction, okay, obviously because A vector is greater. Here I can write R vector equal to A vector plus B vector, remember. Because R vector did not come from the subtraction, magnitude of R vector or R equal to, or this is what? This is R vector magnitude equal to A minus B. So magnitude of this vector is A minus B. But this vector came from where? addition of these two vectors, both the vectors act on the same place to give the result. Is it clear? Don't write here r vector equal to a vector minus b vector. No, r equal to a minus b. Magnitude of r vector is a minus b, but r vector equal to a plus b. Everywhere, whatever the angle may be, you are adding two vectors here, not subtracting. You are adding this vector and this vector are applied on a point or added at a point to give the resultant r vector. So in vector form, if you are writing, you have to write like this. But this is not going to be very much useful in all cases. You have to find what is the value of r. So this will be more useful in scalar form. Okay, so this is the second case. Now let us check what is the third case, third special case. At the end, I will make a table for all the special cases, and you have to take the note accordingly. Now this is the third case. In third case, I am taking if theta equal to 90 degree. Theta equal to 90 degree means A vector is like this and B vector is like this. And the angle between them, they may be of different amplitude or different magnitude. Angle between them is 90 degree. Okay. In this case, what will be the formula? R equal to, just a general formula, but put theta equal to 90 degree. A square plus B square plus 2AB cos 90 degree. Okay. Now, what is the value of cos 90? 0. So, if this is 0, this total term becomes 0. So, R equal to A square plus B square root over. This is the answer. And what is the value of beta? Tan beta equal to B sin theta or sin 90 degree divided by A plus B cos 90 degree. Now sin 90 degree is 1, cos 90 degree is 0. So if you put tan beta will be equal to B by A. Okay, it means if the angle between two vector is 90 degree, okay, then the resultant will go somewhere in between this and this angle. Beta is always angle between A vector and R vector. This angle can be given by or beta, where what is the value of r? R value is this and beta value is this. Beta you can find by using this formula and r you can find by using this formula. Okay. Remember that this formula is applicable everywhere, for theta 90, theta 180, theta 0, for everywhere. But why to use this type of formula if you know this much simple formula? Okay, so if theta equal to 90 degree, don't go for this formula. Simply use this formula, you will find the answer. For example, if there are two vectors, let 4 newton and 3 newton acting at an angle of 90 degree, someone will ask you what is the resultant. Okay, so resultant will be how much? R will be equal to A square plus B square. Or I can write 4 square plus 3 square root over, that is equal to 5 newton. And what is the value of beta? I can write tan beta equal to how much? B by A. If this is B, this is A, so it will be 3 by 4. So tan beta equal to 3 by 4. Now this value, what will be the exact value of beta? Here r vector, where r equal to how much? 5 newton. So this will be the resultant and this will be beta. Okay. And this beta value cannot be found here, because in the tan table you will nowhere get 3 by 4 in the general tan table that we are using. We are only using 0 degree, 30 degree, 60 degree, 90 degree and all these value. It does not mean that tan 20 degree does not exist. Tan 20 is there, tan 21 is there, tan 22 is there, tan 22.5 degree is there. They all exist, but that is not in our tan table that we remember. So this value 3 by 4 does not come in the tan table. What is the tan 0? 0. Tan 30 degree 1 by root 3. Tan 60 degree root 3. tan 90 degree tan 90 degree infinite. Tan 45 degree is also there. Tan 45 degree is 1 by root 2. Tan 60 degree is root 3. Tan 90 degree is infinite. So in those values 0, 1 by root 3, root 3, 1 by root 2 and only infinites are there. But this 3 by 4 is not there. It does not mean you cannot find the value of beta. You can find it by using calculator. For exam or in exam you can leave it like this, or you can write it in by using some tan inverse function that I will tell later. Okay. So my here I want to tell you is that if you found that somewhere the angle given is 90 degree, don't go for this formula. Simply remember this formula and use it. Okay. Now special case 4. If A equal to B, if A equal to B is given, any angle is given, but A equal to B is given. Okay. For A equal to B, the formula of R will be like this. R equal to A square plus A square, because B square is A square itself, plus 2 into A into cos theta root over theta value we don't know. Theta can be any angle. So here R can be written as 2A square plus 2A square cos theta root over. Okay. Or I can write it as R equal to, here if 2A square is taken common, it will be 1 plus cos theta root over, or R equal to, I can write it as root 2A into root over of 1 plus cos theta, or I can write it as R equal to root 2A into this formula. If you know in trigonometry, then there is a formula called cos 2 theta formula. Cos 2 theta is given by 1 minus 2 sine square theta, or it is also given by 2 cos square theta minus 1. Okay, it is, there is a formula in trigonometry. For now, if you don't know, you can remember this as the final result also. But let me use this formula and make it somewhat more simpler. If you don't know for now, you can write it as a note. You will read it in mathematics anyway later on. Okay, now from here, these two, I can write, if one I will take to this side, I can write 1 plus cos 2 theta equal to 2 cos square theta. Okay. Now, what I will do, in place of 2 theta, if I am making it theta, in place of theta, I have to write theta by 2. Yes or no? If theta is 30, then 2 theta is 60. But if theta I am making 15, then obviously 2 theta will be how much? 30. So, if theta I am making theta by 2, 2 theta will be theta. Okay. So, I can write this formula now. 1 plus cos theta equal to 2 cos square theta by 2. This is a formula in trigonometry. Okay. This formula you have to remember and you can use it here. Now, if you use it here, what it will become? 2 cos square theta by 2. Now, can anyone tell me why I have written this form in place of this? Because this root over is difficult. You cannot find the root over of this term. But now, these things root over can be found easily. And what will be that answer? I can write here R will be equal to root 2 into A into its root over will be root 2 into cos theta by 2. Now root 2 into root 2, they are multiplied and they became 2 into A into cos theta by 2. Okay, so R will be equal to 2 A टू ए कॉस थीटा बाय टू, इट इज ए आंसर. नाउ लेट अस फाइंड व्हाट इज द वैल्यू ऑफ बीटा. इज इट क्लियर? सो इफ ए इक्वल टू बी इज गिवेन, यू डोंट हैव टू गो फॉर दिस फॉर्मूला, यू कैन सिंपली यूज दिस फॉर्मूला. ओके, इफ यू अंडरस्टैंड व्हाट इज ए इक्वल टू बी मीन्स, अलोंग दिस डिरेक्शन लेट ए 3 न्यूटन फोर्स इज देयर, अलोंग दिस डिरेक्शन लेट ए 3 न्यूटन फोर्स इज देयर एंड लेट एंगल इज 60 डिग्री, एंड समवन इज आस्किंग यू व्हाट इज द रिजल्टेंट, देन डोंट हैव टू गो फॉर दैट फॉर्मूला, यू कैन सिंपली राइट आर इक्वल टू 2a cos थीटा बाय 2. 2a cos थीटा बाय 2 मीन्स 2 इंटू ए इज 3 इंटू कॉस थीटा बाय 2. थीटा बाय 2 मीन्स 60 डिग्री बाय 2 और इक्वल टू 2 इंटू 3 इंटू कॉस 30. सो आर इक्वल टू 3√3 न्यूटन. ओके, आई एम जस्ट राइटिंग इट फॉर न्यूटन, मीन्स फॉर फोर्स, डज नॉट मीन दैट इट इज ओनली एप्लीकेबल फॉर फोर्स, इट इज एप्लीकेबल फॉर एनी काइंड ऑफ वेक्टर. सो इफ यू आर सीइंग दैट दीज टू आर सेम, मैग्नीट्यूड ऑफ दीज टू वेक्टर्स आर सेम, देन यू कैन सिंपली यूज आर इक्वल टू दिस फॉर्मूला. नाउ लेट अस चेक व्हाट इज द वैल्यू ऑफ बीटा इन दिस केस. व्हाट इज द जनरल फॉर्मूला फॉर बीटा? टैन बीटा इक्वल टू बी साइन थीटा, बट हियर आई एम नॉट गोइंग टू राइट बी बिकॉज ए इक्वल टू बी, सो ए साइन थीटा डिवाइडेड बाय ए प्लस ए कॉस थीटा. ओके, नाउ इफ यू विल राइट इट, टैन बीटा विल बी इक्वल टू ए कैन बी टेकन कॉमन साइन थीटा डिवाइडेड बाय हियर ए इक्वल टू 1 प्लस कॉस थीटा. ओके, नाउ दिस एंड दिस आर कैंसलिंग आउट और इम्प्लाय दैट टैन बीटा इक्वल टू साइन थीटा डिवाइडेड बाय, सी हियर 1 प्लस कॉस थीटा, व्हाट यू कैन राइट 1 प्लस कॉस थीटा, यू कैन राइट एज, ओके देर इज अनदर फॉर्मूला ऑल्सो इज देयर फॉर 1 प्लस कॉस थीटा, ओके लेट मी राइट इट लाइक दिस. सो हियर 1 प्लस कॉस थीटा आई कैन राइट इट एज 2 इंटू कॉस स्क्वायर थीटा बाय 2. ओके, 2 इंटू कॉस स्क्वायर थीटा बाय 2. नाउ देर आर सम ट्रिगोनोमेट्रिक शेप यू कैन सॉल्व. नाउ आई एम जस्ट लिविंग दैट बिकॉज दैट इज गोइंग टू बी लेंथियर. हियर यू विल गेट टैन ऑफ थीटा बाय 2. ओके, दिस इज फॉर असाइनमेंट, दिस इज आई एम गिविंग यू एज असाइनमेंट, दिस इज एक्चुअली मैथमेटिक्स ट्रिगोनोमेट्री. इफ यू हैव अंडरस्टूड ऑलरेडी, इफ यू हैव ऑलरेडी स्टडीड अबाउट ऑल दिस, देन यू कैन सॉल्व दैट. अदरवाइज फॉर नाउ यू लीव एंड यू जस्ट रिमेंबर दैट बीटा विल बी इक्वल टू थीटा बाय 2. यू कैन सॉल्व दिस टू गेट टैन थीटा बाय 2. अलोंग दिस साइड यू विल गेट टैन थीटा बाय. नाउ जस्ट कंपेयर दिस टू टैन बीटा इक्वल टू टैन थीटा बाय 2. सो बीटा इक्वल टू थीटा बाय 2. ओके, सो व्हाट इज द रिजल्ट ऑफ बीटा यू आर गेटिंग? बीटा इक्वल टू थीटा बाय 2. नाउ दिस इज अ वेरी इंटरेस्टिंग रिजल्ट, मीन्स व्हाट एवर द एंगल मे बी, व्हाट एवर द एंगल बिटवीन ए एंड बी मे बी, द रिजल्टेंट विल ऑलवेज गो इन बिटवीन देम. दिस वॉज बीटा, सो बीटा विल बी एग्जैक्टली थीटा बाय 2, मीन्स दिस एंगल इज गोइंग टू बी 30 डिग्री. So I can directly write here beta equal to 30 degree. You don't have to do any calculation. You don't have to go for this calculation. If A equal to B, then beta will be equal to theta by 2. It means, let me again solve it with an other example. If 7 Newton along this direction and let another 7 Newton along this direction making an angle of 50 degree with each other. Making an angle of 50 degree. Now in which direction the resultant will go? In which direction it will go? It will go exactly in between them, or the angle will be equal to 25 degree. Don't have to do any calculation. Don't go for this calculation. Simply use this formula. If A equal to B, then beta will be equal to theta by 2. Means the resultant will go exactly half between this angle. or this resultant will bisect this angle. You can tell like that. So this is a very interesting result and also a very important one. This also you can use, but not in all the cases. In all the cases it is not going to be very much easier. Like in this case, if it is 50 degree and you will get cos 25 degree, that will be difficult. Okay, so that result, this result is an important one. Okay, now let us come for the next case, next special case, case number 4. Remember that the derivations are not that much important in all these cases, although this derivation was important that we have did yesterday, but the derivation that I am doing now were not important. Only the results are very important, very very important for class 11 and for class 12 also. Now let us write the case number 5. Let A equal to B and theta equal to 90 degree. A equal to B is also given and theta equal to 90 degree also given. Okay. Now let us check what is the result we are going to get. We have already found the result if theta equal to 90 degree. What was the result? R equal to A square plus B square root over, and beta equal to, or tan beta equal to B by A. This was the result we got. Now again in this result there is a special formula is there, or special case is there, put A equal to B also. So what will be the value of R now? A square plus A square root over, or R equal to root 2A. And what is the value of tan beta? Tan beta equal to A by A, because B by A by A, or it is 1, or beta equal to 45 degree. It means if there are two vectors, A vector and B vector, but their magnitudes are same, means it is also let 5 Newton, it is also let 5 Newton. You cannot write A vector and A vector. These two vector cannot same. It is along this direction, this is along this direction. For two vectors to be same, what is the condition? They both be of same magnitude and same direction. So you cannot write A vector and A vector. I am writing it is A vector and B vector. Of both are having same magnitude. A equal to 5 and B equal to 5. Now what will be the resultant? You don't have to go for that result. You can simply draw the resultant here, resultant vector, where R will be equal to how much Newton? Root 2 A, means root 2 into 5, or 5 root 2 Newton. And what is the angle is going to be? 45 degree. Angle with A vector or beta will be equal to 45 degree. Obviously, it will be 45, because if these two vectors are same, then obviously this angle is going, this resultant will going to intersect this angle, means it will be 45 degree. This is the fourth case. Now let us write to the last and the fifth special case, that is if A equal to B and theta equal to 120 degree. It's a special case. If A equal to B and theta equal to 120 degree. Let us say what is happening. If A equal to B and theta equal to 120, these two you have to apply in these formulas. Okay. So what is the value of R? R will be equal to A square plus 2A into A into cos 120 degree root over. Or you can do one thing, we found the formula for this, A equal to B, in that case that put theta equal to 120 degree, you will find the answer also. So R equal to, this is, okay, let me try to make this again, let me write like this. From A equal to B, for this we have found a formula that R equal to how much? 2 into cos theta by 2. I found a formula, 2A into cos theta by 2, okay, and we also found the formula beta equal to theta by 2. So for this case, again put theta equal to 120 degree here, because here both the cases are applied. These formulas are only for A equal to B. Now theta is also 120 degree given. So what is the value of R will be 2A into cos 120 degree by 2, or imply that R equal to 2A into cos 60. Cos 60 is 1 by 2. So cancel out and you are getting R equal to A. This is also a very interesting result. I will explain. And beta will be equal to theta by 2 or 120 by 2, that is equal to 60 degree. What do you mean by this result? If there are two vectors, let a 5 Newton force along this direction and another 5 Newton force along this direction are acting at an angle of 120 degree to each other, then what will be the resultant? R will be equal to A, means, and beta equal to 60 degree, means the resultant is again going to be 5 Newton and this angle is going to be 60 degree. See the beauty here. 5 Newton plus 5 Newton is giving you same 5 Newton. If the angle is 0 degree, you are getting 5 plus 5, 10. If the angle is 90 degree, you are getting 5 square plus 5 square root over. If the angle is 180 degree, you are getting 0, 5 minus 5. But here, it is a very special case. If 5 Newton and 5 Newton acts at an angle of 120 degree, what is the result you are going to get? 5 Newton. 10 Newton plus 10 Newton at 120 degree, what is the resultant? 10 Newton. 20 Newton plus 20 Newton at 120 degree, what is the resultant? 20 Newton. So, if the angle between two equal vectors means two vectors having equal magnitude, not equal vectors, two vectors having equal magnitude is 120 degree, then the resultant will be the same magnitude, a resultant will be of same magnitude, 5 Newton. Okay, so these are the five cases, and the angle is obviously half, because these two are same, means the angle will be half every time. If these two vectors are same, whatever the angle may be, the resultant will go exactly in between the angle, or exactly in half of the angle, or it will bisect the angle. Okay. So, whatever result we got, let me just write it down in a single table, and you have to remember that table carefully. What are the? This is the first or the general case. This is a must to remember, with the derivation and the results. Because if in any case, if you are going to forget the special cases, then you can use this. Okay, that will be a bit lengthy, but the answer will surely come. Okay. Now, what are the special cases? You can make a table like this and you can write the answers. Write the special cases here. First case, if theta equal to 0 degree. Okay, theta equal to 0 degree, we can show the diagram also here. A vector along this direction, B vector. This is mean theta equal to 0 degree. Then what are the result you are going to get? R equal to A plus B and beta equal to 0 degree. Means R vector will also go along this direction. If A is this, B is this. Or let me do it like this, let me write it, the cases and the diagram separately. This is the case, this is the result, and this is the diagram. If theta equal to 0 degree, R equal to A plus B and beta equal to 0 degree. What does this mean? This mean this. If A vector is like this, B vector is like this, then R will go like this, where R will be equal to A plus B. Okay. Now, second case, if theta equal to 180 degree, then you are going to get two case. Here you are going to get two case. If A greater than B, then R equal to A minus B and beta equal to 0 degree. If B greater than A, then R equal to B minus A and beta equal to 180 degree. Okay, what does this mean? It means if A vector is like this and B vector is like this, then this is the R vector. Okay, and if A vector is like this, B vector is like this, then R vector will come like this. Similarly, like this, you complete this table for all the five cases. This is your assignment I am giving for the fourth table, and for the fifth case, you fill all this column. Okay, fill the table. This is your assignment, and remember the result very carefully. You are going to use that. Okay, now let us come to the next part of this video, where we will derive some of the, we will understand this equation somewhat in a different manner, or some we will make some notes out of these results. Okay, and we will solve some numericals also. Okay. So let us understand how to take the value, which value you have to take A and which value you have to take B in a given question. Because in question they are not going to give any A and B. For example, if a question is there that there are two forces, or let there are two velocities, one is 3 meter per second and another velocity is let 3√3 meter per second, are acting at an angle of 90 degree. Find the resultant velocity. This is the question. Now, how to know which one you have to take A and which one you have to take B? Because in the question it is not given that A equal to this and B equal to this. So, if one student tells that, sir, if I will take this as A and this as B, then will there be any problem? Will the answer come same or they will different? And if the answers are coming different, then how is it possible? Because a formula should not change according to which one you are taking A and which one you are taking B. Then how this formula I can tell that this is correct in every case? Let us solve this in two ways. First, let me assume this as A, okay, and this as B. And let me find the answer. I am not using the special case here. Although the angle is 90 degree, I can use a special case. I am not using the special case here. Okay, I am simply using by this. For now, for making you understand. Now, in this formula, what will be the value of R here? R will be equal to 3 square plus 3√3 square plus 2 × 3 × 3√3 into cos 90 degree root over. Okay, so cos 90 is coming as 0, so it will be R equal to 9 plus, this will be 9 × 3, that will be 27 root over, or imply that R equal to, this is 36 root over, or imply that R equal to 6 meter per second. Means what is the net velocity is going to be 6 meter per second, and what is the value of beta is going to be tan beta equal to B sin theta. B I have taken this, so 3√3 sin theta divided by A plus, A means 3, plus B into cos theta. Now sin, cos 90 is 0 and sin 90 is 1. So by putting this value, I will get tan beta equal to how much? Here I am getting as this total, this is 0 means this total term is 0. So it is 3√3 into 1 by 3, or tan beta equal to root 3. Now if you remember the tan table, tan 60 was root 3. So, tan beta is root 3 means beta will be equal to 60 degree. Okay, this I have solved by taking this as A and this as B. Okay, now let me interchange. Now someone tells that this is A and this is B. And now let me solve it along this direction. Now what is the value of r is going to be? Obviously r is going to be same. A square means 3 root 3 square plus b square plus 2 into a into b into cos theta, which is 0 here. This much root over, or imply that r equal to 27 plus 9 root over, or equal to root 36, or r equal to 6 meter per second. So r is coming same. There it was also coming 6 meter per second. Here also it is coming 6 meter per second. There is no issue here. Now let us go for the beta one. Tan beta equal to b sin theta. What is b here now? 3. So 3 into sin 90 degree divided by a plus b cos theta. What is a here? 3 root 3 plus b is 3 into cos theta, means into cos 90 degree. Now again cos 90 is 0, sin 90 1. So tan beta become 3 by 3 root 3 or equal to 1 by root 3. Now in the table, tan table, if you remember, tan 30 was 1 by root 3, tan 30. It means beta you got is 30 degree. What is the beta value you got there? 60 degree. Now what is the beta value you are getting here? 30 degree. R has no problem, R is coming same. Now which is correct? Whether this person has done correctly or this person has done correctly? They both are getting a different answer. So which one I will take A and which one I will take B? Because I am getting different answer. Which one is incorrect? Both are correct. How both are correct? See, in the derivation, see the diagram. The beta is always the angle with the A vector. We have derived in such a way that beta is the angle between R vector and A vector. So in this case, this beta you got, R was along this direction somewhere here, or R is somewhere, let R is somewhere like this. This is your R vector, or this is your, how much, 6 meter per second vector, R vector. Now what is your A now in this case? This is your A. So what will be your beta here? Your beta is this angle between A vector and R vector. So this person got that this angle is 30 degree. Now what this person got? For this person, this was A. Yes or no? He has taken this as A and this as B. So if he is taking this as A, then beta will be between A vector and R vector. So this is the beta value he got as 60 degree. And you can see both are same thing. From here 60 degree or from here 30 degree, both are same meaning. He told that the resultant will go with 60 degree with the 3 meter per second. He told that the resultant will go with 30 degree from the 3 root 3 meter per second. And both are same. From here 30 degree, from here 60 degree. Same thing, because total is 90 degree. Is it clear? So, first person took this as A, he got this answer. Second person got this as A and he got this answer. And both are the same meaning. So although the answers look like different, although here beta and here beta value are different, and you may feel that the answers are different, but no, the answers are actually same. The meaning of the answers are actually same, because this person has measured from here and this person has measured from here, from A. Okay, and both have the same meaning. So remember here very carefully the conclusion of this example. If you understood all this, then it's okay. If you have not understood, remember it in one line. What is that? This beta is always measured with the A vector, from the A vector, or it is the angle between A vector and R vector. Whichever force or whichever velocity or whichever vector you are taking as A vector, the beta is the angle between that A vector and the resultant vector you are getting. Now you can choose your A vector, anyone, and accordingly you will find the value of beta. And beta value is always with A vector. You cannot tell that, sir, I will choose this as A vector. and I will write this in the angle. No, if you have chosen this angle, then beta is here. If you have chosen this as A, then beta is here. Okay, I think this point is clear. Now let us come to the next point. Here, another point is there. What is the maximum value if you are adding two vector, and what is the minimum value if you add two vectors? Means, okay, let me first solve, then I will let you know what is the answer. I want to find maximum value of the resultant. Maximum value of the resultant. Maximum value and its condition. For what value or in which case R will be maximum, because we have seen that R depends upon theta. If theta changes, this R value is going to change. So for what value R is going to be maximum, and what is that maximum value that we want to find here. Now remember one thing, sin theta and cos theta both lie between, this both lie always between minus 1 and plus 1. Okay, there is no value of, there is no such angle for which sin theta can be less than minus 1 or can be greater than 1. Similarly, there is no value of theta for which cos theta is less than minus 1 or greater than 1. This is not applicable for tan theta, remember. Not at all applicable for tan theta. For tan theta, its value can be from minus infinite to plus infinite, means value can be anything. But for sin and cos, maximum value is 1 and minimum value is minus 1. Okay, now remember this one. So R value is this much. Now if you want to maximize the value of R, here R, A and B are fixed. A and B are given as, you cannot change A and B. You are given with two vectors, you cannot change them. It is asked what angle should be there between A and B so that your resultant will be maximum. How to find? Obviously, see, R will be maximum if this total will be maximum. Now, when this total can be maximum? A and B are fixed, here A and B are fixed. So, when cos theta becomes maximum, 2AB cos theta will be maximum. Similarly, this will be maximum and R will be maximum. Okay, so I can write here like this, R tends to R maximum when cos theta tends to cos theta maximum, like this it is written. Okay, it means whatever I have written, it means R will be R maximum when cos theta will be cos theta maximum. And what is the cos theta maximum value equal to? 1. Just now I told, cos theta maximum value can be 1. Now if cos theta is 1, if you put in that equation, now cos theta equal to 1, or now I can write, now putting cos theta equal to 1, R equal to A square plus B square plus 2AB root over, because cos theta became 1. Or I can write R equal to A plus B whole square root over, or I can write R equal to A plus B. And when it is possible, what is the condition then? Condition is what? Cos theta equal to 1. Now if cos theta equal to 1, theta equal to 0 degree, because we know cos 0 equal to 1. It means, if you are given with any two vectors, let I am giving you two vectors, 5 Newton and 7 Newton, two forces, 5 Newton and 7 Newton. And I am telling you, act them in such a way that the resultant will be maximum. Then with what angle you should apply them? 0 degree. And what is the result you will get in that case? Obviously A plus B. This also already we have proved that if theta is 0, R equal to A plus B. This already we have proved also, and here also you can check. Is it clear? So if there are two vectors and you have to apply those two vectors with different angles, you will get the maximum when the angle between them is 0 and the maximum will be a plus b. Okay. Now similarly, if the question is, I am just writing it here itself, you have to write in separately in your copies. What is the minimum value of the result under this condition? So r must be r minimum when cos theta will be cos theta minimum. If this decreases, then this total term decreases. If this term decreases, this total term decreases or r decreases. So r will be minimum when r will be r minimum or minimum when cos theta will be cos theta minimum. Now what is the value of cos theta minimum? Minus 1. Now put it here, putting cos theta equal to minus 1, you will get this or this or this. And cos theta will be equal to minus 1 means theta will be equal to 180 degree, because cos 180 is minus 1. So if you are given with two vectors and you have to find a resultant which must be minimum, less than that is not possible, then at what angle you should apply them? At an angle of 180 degree. And what is that minimum value must be? A minus B. Now let us understand this result with a simple example. If I am giving you two vectors, let two forces, 7 Newton and 5 Newton, and I am asking you, what is the result, what are the results may be, what can be the minimum result, what can be maximum result. According to the answer, what is the maximum result possible? 7 plus 5, that is 12 Newton, and what is the minimum result possible? 7 minus 5, that is 2 Newton. It means, and when the maximum result will come? When 7 Newton and 5 Newton will be along the same direction or with at 0 degree. Then the answer will be 5 Newton. Now, 12 Newton. Now rotate this 5 Newton like this. The result will goes on decreasing, 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 decreasing. You can check it. Keep this angle 30 degree, 60 degree, 90 degree, 120 degree, 150 degree like that. And you will find that the results are going to decrease. Means make the angle between 7 Newton and 5 Newton as 30 degree, you will get a result. Between 60 degree, 90 degree, 120, 150, you keep different angle and check the results. You will find that the result will decrease from 12 Newton gradually it will decrease and it will become 0, it will become 2 Newton when the angle between this 7 Newton and 5 Newton is 180 degree. Is it clear? It means 7 Newton and 5 Newton, these two vectors, if they are applied on an object, they cannot give you more than 12 Newton. Neither they can give you less than 2 Newton. You cannot get less than 2 Newton, you cannot get more than 12 Newton. And all the other angles will surely give you answer between these two, between 2 Newton and 12 Newton. Okay? So if you don't know the angle, we don't know, if you know the angle, then we can find the exact result. What is the value will be? What is the resultant will be? But it is sure that the resultant will lie between 2 Newton and 12 Newton, because 2 Newton is minimum and 12 Newton is maximum in this case. So that is what we got. Two vectors added, they can give you a maximum of a plus b when the angle is 0 degree, and they can give you a minimum a minus b when the angle between them is 180 degree. So this is one point. Take note for all these points. These are important points. Now another point. It is a very small point, actually related to trigonometry, but I have to tell it here. Let us take the same example that I have taken sometime before. If there are two vectors, 3 Newton and 3 root 3 Newton, and the angle between them is 90 degree, and it is asked about the resultant. And we have found, you can check this sometime before we have solved, we found that r equal to some 6 Newton or meter per second I have taken, I think, at that time. So it is 6 Newton, and beta I got is 60 degree. From here 60 degree, or from here 30 degree. I have found that. But sometimes you may not find the exact value of beta in just writing with a pen and paper. You have to use the calculator. But in exam calculators are not allowed. So in that case, how to write the answer? Let me tell you what I am telling. Let me explain you. Let it is 4 Newton. R value is, leave that for R value. Now, how to write the beta value? As the formula we know, tan beta equal to, according to that formula, let I am taking it as B and taking it as A. So, B sin theta means 3 root 3 into sin 90 degree divided by A plus mean 4 plus B into cos theta. This becomes 0 and this becomes 1. So, tan beta becomes how much? 3 root 3 by 4. In this case, in the previous case, when it was 3 Newton, you are getting a result as tan beta equal to root 3. Now, if tan beta equal to root 3, this root 3 is available in your tan table. So, you are remembering that, okay, tan 60 degree was root 3. So, beta equal to 60 degree you are writing. Okay, but here, this value is not available in your tan table. In your tan table, whether is there any 3 root 3 by 4 is there, that we remember the tan table. No. That does not mean again this value is not available. In your table, it may not be available, but tan of some angle, it may not be 30, 60, 90 like that. It may be 29, it may be 25, it may be 31, it may be 31.2. For any angle, this value will be this much. And you can get that value by using calculator. But in exam, how to write the value of beta? We have to find the value, write the value of beta, not tan beta. So, how to write the beta here? Here, beta can be written as beta equal to tan inverse of 3 root 3 by 4. Like this, you write and leave your answer. Now, in your calculator, if you have scientific calculator or in your mobile, scientific, go to the scientific calculator and check, there is something written tan inverse. Now put tan inverse 3 root 3 by 4 and you will get the answer. Okay. So, and this function is known as inverse trigonometric function. Sin theta, cos theta, tan theta, cot theta, they are trigonometric function. Sin inverse, cos inverse, tan inverse, sec inverse, cosec inverse, cot inverse and all that were inverse trigonometric functions. Okay. So, basically if I want to write this, I can write it like this. If tan of x equal to y, then I can write the same thing as x equal to tan inverse of y. They are same meaning. Tan x equal to y or x equal to tan inverse y, they have same meaning. For example, if I am writing tan 30 degree equal to 1 by root 3, I can write 1 by root 3 equal to tan inverse 30 degree. Okay, they are same meaning. They are just two different kind of representation. Okay, like you are writing 2 into 3 equal to 6 or 6 divided by 2 equal to 3. They are just two same thing into different method of representation. Similarly, these two are exactly same thing into different methods of representation.